This is Josiah Plays The Witcher 2 Assassins of Kings Enhanced Edition. No! I was dodging. I was pressing the dodge button and it was just a moment too late. I couldn't tell if those Kedwini guys were actually attacking me or not. I would actually like it if I get to butcher all the monsters and butcher all the Kedwini guys. That'd be cool. I have to remember to switch swords.
Guess they'll never learn.
Oh, Greater Rot Fiend, hello! I'm hurting. Swords, just in case these guys want to act up. They're not saying anything. A lot of rot fiends around. Does not bode well for when you have to fight in the mist and you don't have a bunch of people helping you. But when you have to actually go in the mist and really fight, things are different. Everything in there doesn't one-shot you. I don't think these guys realize who I am.
I smell a Temerity.
Or maybe they do. You know what I wish? I wish that the bodies showed up on the mini-map like they do in the other game, Witcher 3. Can I kill these guys if I choose to?
I'll pull your legs out of your arse!
Did they hire a witcher?
Okay, the answer is no, I cannot kill these guys. They're the enemy though. I'll be killing them later when they attack Vergen. That portrait artist did a terrible job for the wanted posters. Nanimus says, every time I see a monster called Greater Axe, it feels awkward around X from there on. Oh. A troll. Is it a friendly troll? No, it's not friendly at all! Oh my god, it's kicking my ass!
Take that.
Not even remotely fucking friendly. Wow. That troll is a lot tougher than the first troll by the bridge near Flotsam.
A lot tougher.
Okay. All right. Wait, did I not save? Starting to feel like I didn't save. Oh god, oh god, oh god!
Damn.
Never mind, he's pretty easy. I just have to not be a noob. Just a random troll. Troll skin. Troll tongue. Troll trophy. Troll trophy gives you 9 damage, huh? That's pretty serious. I think I'm gonna stick with the one I'm using, though. 3-4 damage, 25 vitality, and 2 bonus on signs. Also, what is up with this strange figurine that I found? Is it what I think I know what it is, but I didn't think it was acquired where I acquired it. So my memory is only halfway telling me what's going on with that. I'm sure it I've largely forgotten. What's in here? Nothing. I like the fact that you can find these extra big monsters hanging around and fight them. Like the troll and the Arrakis and stuff. Even though there are definitely no fucking plants on this side of the... Which is super weird. Oh good, more harpies. This troll isn't drunk nor dealing with the emotional trauma of being married to a piece of taxidermy. Don't you guys know I'm the bird man? You can't fuck with the bird man. You can't fuck with the bird man. The bird man you can not fuck with. Oh my god, the AoE art is awesome! Wow. I just froze there. Oh my god, there is a plant! There's one plant in this entire realm. How'd that one slip past the no plants on this side of the mist filter? Okay, never mind. It's plant fucking topia over here. Oh my god. Just after complaining about how there's no plants, suddenly I start finding tons of plants. Your mom used to sing you that song before you went to sleep when you were younger. What? I don't suppose I can go in here. Nope. I've tried my new Aard a bunch. I should try my new Axii as well. See what Axii rank 3 is all about. Where am I even going? Hey now, Bryonia. Don't know what I'm doing, but I found a house. There's the army camp over there with their fires burning. Don't fuck with the Birdman. Ah. New journal entry, Hut on the Cliff. There were many derelict settlements and farms in the area around Vergen. Some had survived in better shape than others. That is not much of a journal entry. Oh, I can Aard those barrels out of the way. Okay, hold up, hold up, hold up. Oh, drowners. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, I can't loot plants because of you. Let's try the new Axii. Fucking him up! And it seems to last quite a while, too. Never mind. Where the fuck is my riposte symbol? There it is. That riposte did a lot of damage. Riposte. Seriously? Dun. I didn't remember being able to explore this much of the other side area when you came over here. I thought you could just explore only a very small amount of it and the rest was like blocked off or whatever. It's the third time you've commented on something in the game and then immediately acted contrary to your observation. What was it? What did I do this time? I don't even notice that I'm doing that shit. See, a lot of people don't realize this, and maybe this is just me. Maybe it's just me. I play games differently when I'm streaming or recording a video for YouTube than I do when I'm just playing on my own. Quite a bit differently. I'm way more absent-minded and forgetful about stuff and just generally spacey and do things a lot dumber when I'm streaming or recording than I am when I'm playing on my own. Because I'm not paying full attention to the game when I'm doing this, because I'm also talking. And I'm thinking about other things. Whereas when I'm what's going on here? Oh, first was flares last a long time, then the flare immediately went out. Next was how there were no plants on this side of the map before plants began popping up, and now with the drowners. Oh, with me saying that it lasts a long time and then it wore off right away? Oh, I'm descending into a hidden cellar! I mean, obviously all of this is for quests when you're on, when you're doing this path of the game and you're normally over here, but it doesn't mean you can't come in here and fuck with it. Okay. Did I summon forth something? Oh my god, I did!
Damn it!
A heart is kind of overpowered sometimes. Did that thing drop anything? 'Cause I like loot. I like how I have to put my sword away to use these candles. Another one, maybe? No, okay. I don't have the quest for this place, so I really can't do anything here. But I got some loot, some free loot out of that. Geralt's world must be tough to live in. Imagine if you couldn't even flip on a light without worrying if you'd be attacked by some otherworldly horror. Yeah. For real. For real, though. How about some more drowners? Some more drowned dead? I just like having stuff to kill. And I like getting loot. Swimmy time. Nope. Alright, Mr. Completionist, here's the deal. Can you say for sure that you looted every single piece of hidden stuff that could be looted everywhere underwater in the entire Witcher 3? Because there's no fucking way. The amount of underwater area there is in The Witcher 3 is ridiculous. So actually exploring all that would be basically impossible. You think you found every major unmarked cache? How could you know that, though? How could you know that you'd found all them if they're unmarked? Unless you checked on a website or something. Which way did I come from? I think it was this way. I do that too, actually, Saito. In fact, I usually do it before I've even finished the game. Like, if I've finished an area, and I'm gonna be leaving the area, sometimes I'll check to see if there's any hidden stuff in the area before I leave. Come on, take with that. It. Did he just dodge that Aard? Where the fuck? There it is. Like, I don't necessarily care about finding every single hidden chest or thing you can loot, but I very much care about finding every quest. Like, I know I never want to miss a whole quest, you know, even if it's a small side quest, it doesn't mean anything. I don't want to miss it. So, hey, there's a dead body here. Ooh, I think I've read that book before. I have, The Life and Death of the White Rose. Okay, that is crazy, Saito. That's like... Oh, I remember this quest. I can't get this quest on this path, but... It's, pretty major quest on the roach path. That's where they killed Sabrina Glevesig, the sorceress who brought down the Rain of Fire on the battle and killed all the people on both sides. That she's been talked to about several times. That is where they burned her at the stake. Oh god, you've got to fight like a million fucking wraiths here, if I recall correctly. I mean, again, nothing's gonna happen like that here now with me, because I'm not on the roach path of the game, but... Compiled a massive spreadsheet about every dialogue note in the game. That's nutty town right there. At least they picked a scenic spot for the burning. Yeah, I don't think that was much comfort for her, though.
How are you?
Who the fuck is this? Oh, this is the Blue Stripes camp.
Hello.
Hey, Blue Stripes. These are roaches, guys. So they're friendly-ish.
What are you staring at? Everything all right, Geralt?
Yeah, everything's fine.
His mother comes and tells him, the Elder and the Recruiter are coming for you. He was slaughtering pigs at the time, so he takes a pig's eye and puts it between his buttocks.
He does what?
Puts a pig's eye in his ass. The Elder and the Recruiter enter, and the mother says, "Son, they've come to take you to war." And he's standing with his back to them, his pants down. He spreads his cheeks and says, "I can see that."
Did they kill him?
Not a chance.
Nice. Nice. Good idea. Oh, hello, loot.
Salutations. Greetings.
Hello. Damn it. Salutations.
I like these guys' armor. They look pretty cool.
Hello. Damn it.
That guy's name is Oven.
Salutations.
Wait, new ability, Pyromaniac, but I already had that ability. Wait, it went up. I think it went up, or maybe it didn't. Maybe it was already 20%. I thought maybe
we
it was 10.
We got orders and got busy preparing to leave the village. She comes up to him and says, "You've promised to come back, and a soldier never lies to his girl."
And did he come back?
Well, after 2 years, with a few scars, having lost 3 fingers to an axe, but return, he did. Then he sees a tyke crawling on the floor and a man holding his gal by the tip. Her eyes go wide and she says, "You're back! What the hell kind of soldier are you?"
Guess she was not expecting him to come back.
Mother comes and tells him, Rabble, the elder and the recruiter are coming for you. He was slaughtering pigs at the time, so he takes a pig's eye and puts it between his buttocks.
He does what?
Puts a pig's eye in his arse. The elder and the recruiter enter, and the mother says, "Son, they've come to take you to war." And he's standing with his back to them.
There's Vess having a little nap now.
He spreads his cheeks and says, "I can see that."
Did they take him?
So much stuff in here.
Leave me alone.
Immediately goes back to snoring. Nice.
In the face of possible disaster, they tried to draft entire villages in
Baywood. I'm bored.
Half the serfs knew beforehand and fled into the woods, but the rest were pressed into service.
I just wilt
the coin says,
quiet.
These are pansies, not soldiers. But we'll have to make do with them. We'll put them out front, let the cavalry run them over. Maybe it'll lose some momentum. So, the battle was on.
How
terrible
are you?
Losses on the left flank. They almost broke our ranks. The serfs dropped their pikes and ran to the archers' corpses.
Did they start looting?
Listen. They picked up the bows and shot at the enemy. I tell you, each shot meant a dead man.
Ah, those were the serfs from Bywood.
Exactly. Poaching is in their blood.
This guy has a lot of stories. Roach doesn't actually wake up, he just says surly things in his sleep. Yeah, exactly. That's kind of how it seemed. Alright, Roach's encampment. They have some pretty fucking cool looking tents.
We got our orders and got busy preparing to leave the village. She comes up to him and says, "You promised to come back, and a soldier never lies to his girl."
And did he come back?
Ha! After 2 years, with a few scars, having lost 3 fingers to an axe.
And here's the palisade wall around the main army encamp itself. And it's, I mean, he's got 5,000 men encamped in here, so it's pretty... That's why he's never had a long-term relationship. Wonder if what happens if I go up to these guys at the gate? Oh, there are no guys.
What are you looking for, Serf? Away with you.
Serf? I'm a fucking witcher. Maybe I'll find some hidden shit over here. Kind of hard to keep a partner after they wake up to you yelling, "Get out, you whoreson!" Yeah. Multiple times per night. Ah, more bodies to burn. That means there's probably going to be some more necrophages over here. Seems like harpies are going to attack me soon. I vaguely remember this area as being harpy-tastic. Oh, I reached the tunnel. Well, no, I didn't mean to reach the tunnel. I'm not ready for that. Our hero decided to make for the tunnel leading to the Nilfgaardians by going straight through Hensoldt's camp. Obviously, he couldn't simply walk between the soldiers' tents. He crept through the shadows, looking for cover behind tent walls, and gave a wide berth to the guards. He tried to be as silent as snowflakes falling onto drifts. Actually, I didn't have to do any of that. I just walked around to the side of the place, and I don't think I want to come this way right now. You don't know why, but the idea that Roach has some bizarre sleep specific to rats makes me love him even more. Oh, Roach. What a character. I like Roach a lot more than Yorvith, actually. But I like Yorvith's side more than I like Roach's side. I'm just right back here. Like, I like Yorvith as a political entity more than I like Roach as a political entity. But as a person, as a personality, I like Roach more than Yorvith by a considerable margin. Especially if you imagine him doing it as a child. Yeah. As soon as he learns to talk, he's already... Found another house. I thought there were a shitload of harpies around here. Look at all these lit candles. Who lit all these candles? Oh, I guess this guy. The Visionary's Notes 3. Where the fuck is the Visionary's Notes 1 and 2? There's two. Alright. Where's one? I hate starting from, like, not the beginning of a series. I'll be back, Visionary. I'll be back. You can do this quest, really? I didn't think you could do any side quests over here. Once you came over, you know. Ooh. Who the fuck keeps five orins in a chest? Five? Chests are for more than that. I just ran straight through an aspen tree. To see if there's anything like behind the house, but I don't think I can go behind the house. All right. Notes 2. Notes 3. He probably has notes 1 on him. Let's read these. My road to the light, the second fragment. We nailed Miss Glevesig to a wheel. We pierced her slender hands and throttled her narrow waist with a rope. The pyre was readied beforehand. Henselt laughed and encouraged us to mock her, so we did. As the flames licked the wood, I looked into her bright eyes, yet I could see no fear in them, only peace. I trembled for the first time. I trembled once again as the flames themselves starved. The fire would not accept the victim. Then Henselt ordered to feed the flames with more wood. The branches were wet, and the smoke stung our eyes, filling us with remorse. Through the flames I could see Miss Glevesig suffocating, and I trembled for the third time. I grabbed a spear used to push the wood on the pyre. Unmindful of the heat, I scaled the flaming wood and pierced her heart. Thus was I transformed in the fire. Ah. So the fire wouldn't burn her. He had to kill her with a spear. Henselt was furious that I had ruined his spectacle. I was beaten to a pulp. Soon I was stripped of my rank, and those I had thought friends turned from me. I started drinking more than ever and sank into sloth, so I was regularly punished. I spent all my free time in solitude, until one day, as I sat with a bottle of foul spirits, staring at a sizzling candle stub, I understood that it had all happened for a reason. I had a calling. The flicker that Miss Glevesig had lit within me spread over my heart, and it burned with the flame of faith, and that turned him into the visionary, I guess.
Huh? What other matters?
Sure you're not overdoing it with those candles?
Why do you need so many candles? Why not build a campfire?
This is Sabrina's flame. Its light protects us and guides us soldiers every step.
Did you rob a convoy of wax sellers?
I make the candles myself. I give them to anyone looking for protection within the flame of courage.
Who are you?
Who are you?
Our descendants will decide who we were when they see what we've left behind.
Right. Well, who were you then?
Who were you before?
What does it matter? Let the sins of youth fade into oblivion. Look at the candlelight. Feel it, and you'll hear what it has to say to you.
I can't hear a thing.
Then you're not ready. But your time will come. You will then hear and understand. Trust me.
The valley's been engulfed by a battle of specters. Know anything about it?
It's a place of horror. You can still hear the sound of steel and the cries of the dying. If you want to soothe their pain, you have to believe that Sabrina is watching over you benevolently.
I won't achieve anything without some memory tokens. Magically active conduits left by those who fell in battle. They're supposed to symbolize faith, courage, hatred, and death.
Faith? I don't know what those soldiers believed, but their faith didn't help them. They were deceived. Courage, hatred, and death? There was too much of all of them, especially death. But I remember a knight who, ignoring the danger, led a handful of soldiers against overwhelming enemy forces. Selkirk of Gullet, Demoven's champion. When Vandergrift's cohort cut him off from the rest of the army, he attacked the visitor fearlessly. If you're looking for a symbol of courage, find Selkirk's armor.
Okay then, thanks. Nice. Who is this guy? The visionary. During my travels, I've seen many prophets, preachers of divine truth, who frothed and gibbered foretellings about the end of the world, depravity of women, lechery of kings, and rising taxes. The visionary extolled the martyrdom and sanctity of Sabrina Glevesig, and these ideas had become the foundations of a local cult. Supposedly, the sorceress's favor made him invulnerable and safe. However, there was no way to decipher how much truth lay in his tales. You're telling me if I go back to that other house with the basement, I can get a quest there? How do I get a quest there? Do I have to light the candles in the right order or something? Are you sure I can get a quest there? On Yorvith's path? There's some notes in the basement. Really? Because I looted everything you could loot in there. Or there was nothing that you could loot, or whatever. You sure it's lootable when you're on Yorva's path?
Magic or danger?
I think there's another troll or something up ahead. Oh, it's Intrega. Haven't seen you guys in a while. Okay, alright, calm your shit. Big fucking difference fighting Indrega with my new sword rather than the sword I had back then. How many legs do Intregas have? I'm trying to determine how many legs they have. I think they only have four. They might have six. Saito, I literally just read that in the visionary's notes. Were you not paying attention? You can learn it on this path. I literally just read that. This is a big area. I did not remember being able to explore such a large area over here. I mean, it's mostly full of... What the fuck is that? Oh, it's just another Arrakis. Must have missed it during a reload. That's okay. What's up with this little shrine right here? Oh, what is this sword? Arbitrator. It's not as good as mine, but it's a pretty nice sword. If I had found this before getting the sword I've got now, I'd have been pretty happy. It's alright. You can't catch everything. You can't catch everything, Saito. Especially if you're having reloading buffering issues and stuff. Anonymous, how much buffering issues do you get when you watch my stream? Because it's rare that anyone says anything about buffering, but tonight, both Saito and that other person that was here for a little bit were talking about buffering. And I always wonder, are people coming and watching and they're getting a lot of buffering and they're not saying anything? And then, like, they just quit watching or something because of the buffering? I never know, you know? I think I've explored everything here. I really wish I could sprint. Also, it'd be nice to have a horse. I mean, this game doesn't have enough big open explorable area to really make a horse make sense like it does in the... Alright, right. So there's this spot. And there's this spot with his house. So what happens if I do the candles in the right order? Then I just get a quest or what? Ah, there's Letho. Attention! The man depicted here, of unknown name and provenance, is wanted dead or alive. A reward has been set for information about him. Yorveth. Geralt. Ah, okay, I get it now. Well, I'll go back there then. After I'm done exploring everything over on this side. Alright, so this is just the mist over here. This is basically a dead end. Oh, but what about up here? Whoa! Can I get around this mist? Looks like I can. Ah, but this is like blocked off. Unfortunate. You'll be right back. All right. Still here, Anonymous? Oh, what's this? Shillard fits Osterlin's order. He's the Nilfgaardian ambassador guy. By order of His Imperial Majesty, I hereby command the capture of the sorceress Triss Marigold, considered to be at large in Upper Edirne. The sorceress should be brought to me alive and in secret. Not a single hair is to fall from her head. Why did the Nilfgaardians want to capture Triss? What is that about? That is an important little piece of intel, though. Even if I hadn't learned anything to that effect from Roach already, that would lead me to believe that the place to look for Triss would be the Nilfgaardian encampment, which is basically what Roach already told me. But there's some rot fiends. Can I get a riposte? Rod fiends are kind of fun to fight because they have that whole extra element of they're going to explode when they get low, so you have to like keep that in mind. And all right, so there are a shitload of rod fiends around here. And I like that their explosions can actually damage the other rot fiends, so sometimes you can use that against them. You're gone to make some tea? You're presently gone to make some tea, or you were gone to make some tea? Well, if you're here, I asked you what kind of buffering issues you get watching my stream. Does it buffer a lot, or do you not have that problem? Did I get all the loot? Now I think I got all the loot. Nope. Now I think I got all the loot.
Shit, you stink.
I don't know why I set a snare trap just then. Buffering is pretty brutal. I have to refresh it every few minutes. Really? Shit. Maybe I have to reduce my bitrate even more. It's at 2400, which is lower than even some suggested amounts that I could do, lower than some people stream at. But it still might be a little bit too high for people's internet. I mean, how good is your internet? You might have bad internet, and then it's not my fault. Same question to you, Saito. How good is your internet? Pretty good on buffering right now. It's not bitrate? It's not? Well, what else would it be? Run off the university's fiber optic link. I mean, my understanding is the bitrate you stream at determines how much bandwidth or whatever people need to watch your stream without buffering. And if you stream at too much bitrate, then people's internet can't handle it and they get a lot of buffering. And if you stream at a lower bitrate, then more people can watch it without buffering. But of course, the lower the bitrate you stream at, the lower the quality is, and that also applies to the quality of my videos that I make. So I want to stream at the highest bitrate I possibly can, without making it impossible for anybody to watch my stream because of buffering. And I thought the sweet spot for that balance was 2400. But I'm starting to feel like I need to lower it some more. No, 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 shit! Alright, just go ahead and kill me. I don't even know why I ran up there. I'm ready now. I've explored everything I'm going to explore around here. Oh wait, I'm going to go back to that one house. Yeah.
And tells him, the Elder and the Recruiter are coming for you. He was slaughtering pigs at the top.
Now let's see if I can find my way back to that house. Regional servers have low priority for connections outside of their regions. We will descend back into this basement and mess with the candles again. In our next episode. That is going to do it for this one. But thank you for watching. This has been Josiah Plays The Witcher 2 Assassins of Kings Enhanced Edition. Moscow-ish. The Moscow...